moment of silence, please, for the sick, handicapped, departed, and military personnel of this community. Thank you. Before we do a roll call, I'd like to turn this meeting over to Councilman Petrocelli.
For me?
Yes.
I do not need this chairman, Mr. Chairman.
No, I insist.
Wait a minute, you're the chairman now, sir.
You're the chairman.
You're yourself, Dino.
Well, he just wanted to sit next to you.
Your honor, your honor.
That's not right.
Yes, it is.
You understand that? I'm happy to wait till now. I've been here a long time. Okay? Doesn't mean I'm going to wait. That's wrong. As long as my mind is good, if the leg or not, they always could put a ramp over there. which is normal. But anyway, if that's the case, roll call, please.
Mike Tolmer?
Here.
Bruce Galluzzi?
Here.
Nino Petrocelli?
Here.
Jason Zaraznik?
Here.
Bill Kowalski? Bill Henderson?
Here.
Bill Lyon?
Here.
Pat DeBlasio?
Here.
Thomas McDermott?
Here.
Joe Sykes? Lori Conlon?
Here.
Chad King?
Here.
Bill Chilio?
Here.
Dan Miller?
Okay. May I have the sign list? Oh, just right here. Thank you. Dan Calusi?
Hi.
Would you please come to the podium then, please?
Face this way?
This way is fine.
Okay.
Get out of it.
Well, hi. Good evening. My name's Dan Calusi. I'll only take a couple minutes. Me and my wife just moved into the community. And we're very happy to be here. We moved in a couple months ago, and we are living in Greenwood Place, which if you're going down Bank Street is to the right-hand side. And Greenwood Place is considered that whole area back there. Except for the concern I'm bringing to you guys is that my street seems to be a forgotten street with no name. There are few other homes on this street. Our address is 325 Greenwood Place. But on this map, for instance, it is classified as Gilmore Street. This map has it shown as Morningside. Another map online has it as Greenwood Place, like you guys have it called. But then if you go to all GPS services, or Google Earth, Google Maps, Garmin, we show up as Lucy Street. So I have a house that's on a street that has four different names. And our postman can identify that because he's been doing the route for years. But as far as outside services like UPS, FedEx, anything, they have no idea where we are. They think we're on Greenwood Place because Greenwood Place is actually another street closer to Bank Street. So we are a horseshoe off that, and so you have Greenwood Place, and then you have, to get to our horseshoe, you have Gilmore Street and Morningside, and how we, at the end of that, are Greenwood Place, I'm not understanding how. But I guess my proposal is there anything that can be done to change it back to Lucy Street, which appears to be what it was at one point? Or if there's nothing that can be done, is there a way that I could be directed to do something else about it?
There probably will be a consultation with the post office, I believe, number one. We should start there.
Well, normally what the post office does is when there's an address that needs to be added or whatever, and the residents call the post office tells them to call us. And we tell the post office what the address is going to be. So we would say, you know, this is going to be 325 Lucy Street in this place. So we can make that determination. We can, you know,
which house
the street,
is it?
Whatever.
You know the actual, yeah. Okay, so it's, if, yeah.
Oh, you're talking above Bart Elmer.
It's the furthest street overlooking Baldwin and the Power Hill.
His house, I believe, is directly behind bars.
Yes, on the bars.
Your neighbors, what are they using it as an address? That would be.
My neighbor is Mark Dozo. They're using 3333 Greenwood Place. And then there's only three of us.
Yeah, right? I'm just saying we need to get.
Yeah.
Everybody in the same.
Really part of Gilmore.
Yeah, and I guess I'm just wondering if we could get it changed. Is there a way to get everything uniform, like deed? I mean, I have like a lot of things that would need to be changed over to God.
Didn't we have something like that with the EMS about Greenwood and the numbering?
We have a lot of streets like that, but we've had it back in there, and when one of my guys used to work in a post office, they consider it Greenwood.
Right. That whole area back there.
Yeah, because we used to get the calls, we get people saying, no, this is Lucy. No, it's been a big confusion, but you know, the post office, I think, considers it Greenwood.
Right. I mean, they know because they deliver mail there all the time. They, like you said, UPS guy comes.
Yeah, my only other concern, I guess, is that we don't even have a street sign. Like Gilmore and Morningside do. But at the back, like, we don't even have a street sign. Like, if we are to stay just Greenwood Place, we don't have a sign that tells people we're Greenwood Place.
Mark, what is your address? I mean, what do you go by? Greenwood?
Yeah.
It does now.
Yeah, I'm just saying that you are.
Right, for utilities, everything.
Okay.
Prior to the county, you still use Lucy to stand and say. So you'll still see Lucy all over there. Lucy on your map there.
I grew up there and it was never known as anything but Greenwood, but it was a whole area that was Greenwood.
Yeah, the whole area.
And everybody knew everybody else there, so Dan, you know, back then.
Yeah.
There wasn't a problem. But the only problem I have people encounter, there's a Greenwood in South Fayette.
Right.
Yeah. And a lot of people are looking for somebody.
It's Greenwood Drive still.
Yeah, Greenwood Drive.
Yeah.
They get it confused.
Mm-hmm. I hear that.
I've lived where I lived for 47 years, and we still get mail. It's not ours, because we don't have the same postman every day, and he has no clue that it's not addressed properly.
That's not necessarily something wrong.
Yeah, not exactly.
We could possibly explore making it part of the Gilmore. It looks like what happened historically is, looking at the county map, Gilmore as a paper street, when it was laid out, actually continues and keeps going all the way to Hall.
Right.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it doesn't exist in reality.
Right.
Yeah. But in reality, the curve, it just seems like a curve. You would have to talk to the post office, but you could.
Okay.
Possibly make that just part of the building.
Okay.
It seems like earth, that's the way it should be.
Okay. Councilman Petrocelli?
Yes.
If I might have
Yeah.
Mr. Calusi is not alone, as we've noticed. There are a number of these issues in our community, and there is deep within the borough a committee called the Street Committee. And what it does is it looks at these issues for names and numbers of streets. It's a long ago committee that no one has ever actually, it's not been used for many years. I'm going to suggest, or I'm going to ask council if they would not mind if Mr. Calusi, along with myself, and I'm hoping Councilman Petrocelli, if he is not going anywhere, might serve on that, and might work on this issue over the next several months. Not just for Mr. Calusi's issue with Lucy Street and Greenwood, but also with the issue of Greg turning into Greenwood and Chartiers coming off and becoming Lesnut. These are all issues that we could do a good job with someone very new and someone who's been around for a long time. So this is all off the top of my head. I did not speak to anyone, so I apologize for, you know, somewhat blindsiding counsel, but...
Well, I was ready to mention to nominate a committee with this. This way we're not all going to be involved, do the same thing, and nothing gets done. That's okay with me. I'll be more than glad to serve, Let's get it together and come back to the legal department, plus the manager, and slowly we can correct all these things. This is not going to be done in 1 week.
Absolutely. I understand. I was just making it known in case it wasn't known, but it seems like it is very known.
And now you can be part of this.
And we can also dust off whatever the debate rules are, and this conversation could actually approve Judge Smith's ruling, where it is, and it's his constitution, and dusted.
That was my hope.
Okay.
Will do.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
By the way. Like we had, during our public safety meeting, we discovered the street committee, actually, when we were looking at some of the things, and it probably falls under public safety, if that's something that we want to work together with public safety committee, I think that would be appropriate things.
It would be my thought that the street committee would come up with some ideas, and then present it to public safety, and then ultimately the council to ratify the names and places that are most appropriate. This would be just a group that would start to look at the issue.
Okay, very good. We will definitely do that. Frank Daly, please.
Good evening. Mm-hmm. I just thought I'd, I think the last time I was at the council meeting in September, I was expressing the frustration and concern of the 300% increase in the parking meter charges, lot two and the other lot around Bridgeville. Since that time, I've been to two of the parking authority meetings, where the council directed me to, trying to get some answers to my questions on how they established a 300% increase in the fees for parking, along with what's going on with the parking fines. At the first meeting that I attended with the parking authority, I asked what process was put in place to establish that the hourly rate or the rate for parking was going to go from a quarter for an hour to 20 minutes for a quarter. And the best answer, or if there was any answer that I got out of or walked away from that meeting, is that they really didn't do a significant or a detailed evaluation of what needed to be done or how much the parking should be charged here in Bridgeville at the various lots. They did bring up the fact that they were in the hole, losing some money, and that they felt there was a need to increase the parking fees, the meter fees. At that time, at the end of August, if I'm not mistaken, the parking authority was $1,226 in the red year to date. The 300% increase went into effect at the end of August. So you've got September and October financial statements. In the October financial statement, I was just fortunate enough, after about two or three phone calls, it was delivered to the restaurant today. And as of today, or as of the October month-end financial statement, the parking authority now is $6,243 to the positive. And why I have a concern with that is there really was no significant or legitimate business evaluation of what the parking fees should be in Bridgeville. My other piece of the puzzle that I came away from my first parking authority meeting, it was a little disturbing, is they talked about, well, evaluating that, then going out, and if they were to raise the fees, it was going to cost them $35 to recalibrate each meter, all right, to whatever fee they established should have been charged. In the interim, they found that Mount Lebanon had just replaced all their parking meters. And the Bridgeville Parking Authority was able to purchase all those old used meters for $5 a piece. And the coincidence of that is that those $5 meters just happened to be, programmed or calibrated for 75 cents an hour, which is their 300% increase. And that was pretty much the reasoning as to where they landed on 75 cents an hour. So I'm a little concerned with that, because quite frankly, I don't have a problem if they felt that they needed to do something, but I do believe that a legitimate and a reasonable business process should have been followed to establish what the fee should be. Another concern that I spoke with them on was the fine, the administration of parking fines. I've had customers, employees, get a parking fine, pay their fines. Obviously, there's challenges of letting get into all that right now. But one of the things that I've uncovered in the last couple of weeks, which is a little bit concerning, is I had an employee get a parking ticket on a Friday during the day. It's a $9 ticket. Parking tickets are supposed to be $7. She paid her $9. I inquired with Joe as to why this person got a $9 ticket. I was advised that she got a $9 ticket because since they went to the automated ticketing process to keep track, she paid one of her fines late. If you pay a fine late, your next parking ticket or subsequent parking tickets are no longer $7 tickets, but $9 tickets. So I asked Joe, where is that documented at? Is it on the parking ticket that is distributed to the person receiving the violation? No. Is there anything documented in the Bridgeville Parking Authority records or administration or anything about how the fine administration takes place? He could not answer that question for me. Basically, he told me no as far as what he knew, and he could not answer it. So my question was, and so we make up the rules as we go along, which is kind of a disturbance, because if I pay my fine, why am I getting charged something different? All right, than what it says. So that's a little bit of a concern. And he said, well, I asked him that should be something, and next week when they have a meeting, I will follow up and ask him, are we going to document what the administration of the parking fines and violations is going to be? Because I would think that the Bridgeville Council and Bridgeville attorneys or whoever is involved in that would want to make sure that stuff is documented, because if it was me and I got that ticket, I would probably challenge it. All right, because I don't believe you can make up these things as you go along and change the rules. Document.
It also brings up a privacy concern. If we're now maintaining records of people's parking violations, you now know where they were and when they were there, depending on what kind of data. So would that be something?
Could be true. So, I mean, that's one of the things that I brought up. I'm just kind of updating the council, because I'm really not sure the relationship between the council and the parking authority. You know, last month's, or the quarterly newsletter, most recent quarterly newsletter, there was a nice little piece about the parking authority. And I had this at the meeting last month. And I think there's a lot of people in the parking authority who are not even aware that this was in your newsletter that quarter.
It came from their website. It comes from the parking website.
This is, it was in the newsletter too, but the parking authority
right,
folks.
Newsletter.
Okay. And it says it's a separate entity from the Bridgeville Borough government. So I'm not sure what that truly means. It's a separate entity.
To be that the government.
Yeah, so it's a separate entity from the folks, correct? All right. And they're self-supporting, do not rely upon taxpayer dollars to operate. They reinvest all profits back into the upkeep and the possible acquisition of new lots. They also say it's interested in the future of Bridgeville and constantly seeking out opportunities to make parking here more convenient. You know, well, we, everywhere else, Mount Lebanon is $75 an hour. Carnegie's $75, 75 cents an hour. Carnegie's 75 cents. That makes no difference to me. That's no bearing on what we're doing here in Bridgeville. That was one of my other concerns. You know, they establish these things based on what the other communities are. I go back to, what is it that the authority needs to make and maintain these lots, provide parking, and do so at a break even, which is what I would expect that the authority is able to do. One of the things that was shared with me at the last parking authority meeting was, well, we have a proposal here to repay Lot 2 sometime in the next 3 years. that's going to cost $99,000. And that's where this money is going to be earmarked for, to help pay for that. All right? So may or may not really happen. I also go back to the fact that I've discovered that the parking authority owns these lots.
Yes.
Free and clear, from what I understand. So any good business person out there might say, well, you know what? If we think this lot needs to be resurfaced and redone, I might want to go out and use the equity that I have, borrow some money, all right, so money's basically free today, and do the work, and then pay for it over time, like a lot of other places do, instead of trying to collect it, have the money in the bank, and then go pay to have it worked out, which I question whether that's really, you know, I don't know if that was just a means for that parking authority, those folks who tried to push me away, say, well, this is what we're going to kind of die about. Again, the fine administration, I did question the documentation of that. Customer complaints, we're getting complaints from our customers. And we're getting reassured, oh no, those meters are all operational, they all work. Well, I can attest to you they don't always work. Well, yeah, if you tweak it a little bit, you play with it, and make sure your quarter drops. It's not like anywhere else, drop before you turn it, it works. The old meters were a lot more efficient than what these current meters are that are older. So that's a question in part, because I got customers that are thinking they're dealing with wieners that aren't working and they're coming out after lunch or after their visit, and they have tickets. One of the other things that I asked the parking authority to do at the first meeting, and now the second meeting I had no response, now I'm going to look at the third meeting, is if there anything they can do to help our people that work in the community, people that work at my establishment, anything that can be done to help them versus the $45 a month or whatever. Is it $45 a month? For the permits? Larry? Is there any other options available to our folks? And they still haven't really, give me a couple of little options, but nothing significant that we're able to do. The other thing that was nice, they got the signs down, it's a free parking sign. I did ask. Well, instead of just putting a sign up at the entrance on either side, either end of the parking lot, why don't you consider investing a little bit of money in bagging the signs, bagging the meters? Be nice, put a nice little bag on the meters, too late for this year. Put a nice little bag on the meter that says, happy holidays, free parking, compliments of Greenwood Parking Authority. Get a little bit of goodwill out of it. The response I received was, well, we did that before and the bags blew off and then they became a nuisance and a mess in the community. Wow. I'm challenged with that too. They're not that expensive, all right? And then the last thing that I want to address that I'll bring to the parking authority next week that I've also mentioned and haven't gotten anywhere with it is, the meters operate 9 to 6 Monday to Friday. I challenge anybody here to go look for how visible that is to the people using those lots, all right? So recently, an opportunity to go up to Mount Lebanon for lunch. They're brand new meters. So the meter accepts dimes, quarters, tokens for 15 minutes, debit or credit cards. That was one of the other things that was brought up. Most of the times you go into the meters today, they're either have kiosks, they have meters that take dollar bills, not always quarters, because people don't drive around with a bunch of quarters in their car all the time, or credit cards. So I just want to pass this around. This is one of the brand new meters up in Mount Lebanon. And I've asked, I don't think it would be a significant investment. Take a look at the little stickers that are right on the meter, right in front of your eyes when you're trying to put your money into the meter. So that at 6:15 or 6:30 or 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock or any time after 6 o'clock when the meters are not being monitored, people know they don't have to put money in the meters, all right? Well, I can assure you that a lot of money goes in those meters after 6 o'clock. You guys, we could go to the next one. Go to the other side, because there's also a picture in there of the doormat meters, too. Have a nice sticker on it. Now you're in the line.
Yeah,
family stuff. There you go. Here's the doormat. There's the sticker that's on the doormat. I would venture to say we could probably go to Office Max very inexpensively buy those stickers and put them on the meter. That would be weatherproof or waterproof, printed right on it if you wanted to do something. My point being is, I know, I'm assuming that it's, this governing body is not going to be the decision-making process, but I'm hoping maybe some influence could be pushed on to the parking authority, because it is having an impact. It's having an impact on my daily traffic. It's having an impact on people that show up at 7 or 8 o'clock at night and they're putting 75 or a dollar and a half in the meter when they really don't have to. And that's the part that's disturbing. So that's basically what I have to share. Okay. Any questions?
No, I was going to say, there's a meeting next Monday at 7:30. If you don't mind, I'd like to attend. And I know you said you'll be there.
Yes.
Hopefully, you know, we can sit down with the parking authority and kind of, like you said, it is its own governing body. Like you said, and it's separate from council.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, if you're looking for somebody to come from council to kind of hear both sides of it, and because you tell us, and then, you know, we have the parking authority, and then, you know, at least we can all be in the same room together.
Well, that's why I came tonight, because I wanted to give you a little update. Because when I showed up here in September and shared with you, you know, the 300% increase, the frustrations that we were experiencing and continue to experience, you know, you sent me to the parking authority, which is what I was comfortable with. But I just wanted to kind of give you an update of where I've been and what I've been running into since that time. So just a quick math in my head. So in two short months, September and October, we went from a $1,200 deficit to a $6,200 positive. All right, so just round numbers, if that's $3,000 a month on average, well, it won't take them much more than 3 years to get to $99,000 to rebuild the lot. But I think there's a better way to approach it. Again, if they came to us and said, here was the business evaluation and why we went 300%, I don't have a problem with it. But don't tell me it's because you can get $5 meters that are antiquated as compared to something more reasonable. One of my customers posted on her Facebook, boy, look at this, Bridgeville's got, well, not new meters, but different parking meters. Now you better show up with a bunch of quarters in your pocket to go to Burke's Pizza and Wing Pub, all right? One of our, the fellow business people said that we went from the flip phone to the rotary phone, all right? Because you can't have, if you don't have the quarters, because they even tell you, quarters only. The only thing it does tell you is quarters only, all right? And you can't put a dollar in it, can't put a credit card. I think even this, which one here? Oh, Dormont, they said meters enforced Monday to Saturday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. If you don't have the coins, visit meterfeeder.com.
And how does that help?
Pardon me?
How does that help?
They can put their credit card, or they could go with their smartphone right there and go to meterfeeder.com and call them. I have not tried it. But I'm assuming it's the way people can pay their meters right then and there and not to worry about getting their whatever ticket.
What is the maximum that you can get? Is it
2 hours? 2 hours in the majority, yes.
Dollar quarters.
In the majority, yes. So you need a dollar and a half if you were planning on staying 2 hours. If you think you're going to be longer than that, then you can worry about running out and feeding the meter. All right?
Let's have meetings with Mr. Chairman, I think.
I'll attend the meeting.
Yeah, attend the meeting, and maybe prior to that, can get together with a lot of those things are legal. I'm sure the solicitor have some look on that to be legal. Now, in my opinion, to do all those change will cost more money. So they do think in their meaning. And Mr. Falcone knows very well. Mr. Falcone was the parking authority. She knows very, very well what she's talking about. They are, okay, in short term, let's have in the future soon a little communication between this council and the parking authority, a meeting on 101, two or three people.
Yeah.
Many years ago, I stated on record someplace that we actually, this council, quarterly, should have a meeting with the parking authority, with the planning commission, and the zoning. And just in the room, they would have taken a lot of this communication. And I think it's a good idea to think about it, And I know more meeting is more meeting. A lot of us don't want to do that. But Mr. Chairman, I think it's a good idea to look into that. And like you say, let's hear it from the words of the mouth.
Sure.
Thank you. Please come.
Hello, everybody. I'm here to talk about the farmer's market, and the farmer's market is going to be discontinued. We have had 5 years of struggle in the beginning to get the customers and the vendors, and then we had the vendors in a new location, and the vendors stayed all summer, it was really nice, but the customers, we just didn't get enough customers to keep the vendors to come back again for next year. So I am going to discontinue. It's a volunteer position. Everything is still in place in case somebody else wants to take the task on. It takes no investment for next year. It would just, we have everything in place to start up again. So at this point, the farmer's market is discontinued. Sad but true. Okay. Oh, it's my pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks.
And I'll be able to read this, the last speaker here. Oh, who's that? Glenn Fulmer.
Folks. Thank you, sir.
Doctor, yeah, okay.
Sorry. My name is Lynn Foltz, and I'm here representing Dr. Neil Roy in reference to the proposed new office building downtown Bridgeville across from the post office. It presently is fenced off. The other building was demolished, and this is the primary location of Dr. Roy's building. The purpose of my attending your meeting this evening is I understand there are some changes in the works to the zoning ordinances, and we would like to get started in the very significant planning stages of this particular building. Our request to the township is we will be coming in with a conditional use application, and because the zoning changes are going, it appears on your agenda to be adopted this evening, what I need to understand, and Dr. Roy needs to understand, is what are going to be the conditional uses under which we can file an application to the township, or to the borough, excuse me, in order to get this moving through the Planning Commission, Supervisors Commission, Supervisors, and preliminary, and come back for final approval. This is the artist rendering prepared by Mascarino and associates, and this is just a proposed rendering. This is certainly isn't final, and we are welcome to input from the appropriate governmental authorities here in Bridgeville. This is a five-story building. It has approximately 4,000 square feet. We have been to the parking authority in reference to what our requirements are concerned, and I would say they're very supportive, and we've been negotiated X amount of parking spaces here, and then Y amount of parking spaces elsewhere in the borough. So the reason for me being here this evening is to ask under what, I obviously need a copy of the final zoning changes that are being proposed this evening, and then after that, I have to understand what conditions the borough is going to permit us to move forward on this building venture and make the applicable application and pay the appropriate fees for a project of this nature. So that's why I'm here, and I need some direction as far as the zoning ordinances, and we can go from there, please.
Okay, thank you. We have two people here who are very familiar on what's going to happen. It'll be the solicitor and the manager. I'll let the solicitor first tell you, give you an answer.
Yes, sir.
Come.
Thank you. And Mr. Fulton, I had an opportunity actually to speak last week, and I believe he had a copy of the draft ordinance circulated.
Draft, yes.
Yeah, and it has not changed. And I had an opportunity to speak with you last week regarding the only changes, the revisions to the draft since the draft that you got involved the overlay district on Baldwin Street with Lachlan and actually making clear that they're both encompassed in that and that they're applied. The only difference between the overlay, getting ahead of ourselves, the general topic, we've updated and we'll talk in more detail, I'm sure, when the agenda item comes up regarding some of the summary of the changes, but there's been updates to the general business commercial district, now called mixed use district. That applies to the whole borough. However, carved out over in the Baldwin and Walker Run areas end up what they call an overlay. The primary distinction between the overlay district and the general Main Street, Washington Avenue business district, mixed use district rules are that on Baldwin Street, McLaughlin Street, you will be allowed to have first floor multi-dwelling units, as opposed to the architecture of the ordinance always has been and is not changing now, that in the main downtown Washington frontage strip area, the main mixed area, there's rules that limit the extent to which you can put a dwelling unit on the first floor, which does not pertain to you.
Yeah, we're not putting any right. dwelling units so, inside.
Now, generally speaking, and your professionals who are well-versed and we're familiar with, they will, as I explained to you, the application process is really an engineer design kind of driven application. And there's a general application form that you'll fill out with name, rank, and serial number and whatnot, but for the most part, it's your site plan. Because you will file, and by the way, you were asking about what the conditions are. A conditional use is not something we make up as we go along. In the draft that you have, it actually sets out that there's going to be some flexibility within it, but there are basically the rules and standards set out in the draft that you already have regarding.
So I might understand, so that the draft I have really has no significant changes as it would impact this building.
No. No. And the updated draft has been available, and I can forward you actually a digital copy of this.
Could we have the approved draft,
sure,
just for insurance and
yep.
legalities, transfers, and things like that?
Happy to do that.
After it's approved,
sure.
Whatever is approved by the council.
Sure.
That'd be great.
It had been my intention to get that over the weekend, too, but
yeah.
I have the latest pre-draft, but it'll be the same. We can certainly get that out to you. But basically, there's a conditional use application and the companion site plan land development application. Your folks will very well know how to
sure.
get those in there. You file a 14 copy of your plan documents that are going to be submitted. It'll go through the planning commission, then you come to council.
Sure.
And
thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Lori, anything you want to add to it? Jim, you want to add to anything?
No. I do.
Go ahead.
And that's an atrocity.
Mm-hmm.
I think that, first of all, are those offices?
It's professional.
Let me interject. Okay. There's been no application filed. I would recommend the board not comment upon an application that has not been filed, which will be before the board.
That's okay.
If they meet the standards under the ordinance, they're entitled to an approval of a conditional use.
Okay, my opinion, that's an atrocity. It's
again, I'm not to cut folks off. I don't want when the board sits on a zoning application, they sit as a quasi-judicial body. Because we're not in talking about that concept plan, I think the gentleman said that's just a concept plan and not their application. I'm just cautioning folks to wait until a time and place, and there will be a public hearing. Actually, a conditional use comes with a public hearing. It'll go to the planning commission. It'll be scheduled for a public hearing for this body, and that'll certainly be a time when you can
voice
share
my
your
opinions.
Opinions. Yes.
Just one more parking.
No, well, thank you, Liz. Thank you, Tom. Okay, we can go ahead with our regular meeting, if we will. A motion of the Board of Council regarding the minutes of November 9th, 2015. I need a motion.
Second.
Bruce and Brooke and Soresti. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of November 9th, 2015. Public hearing as submitted. You need a motion?
So moved.
Second. Jason and Bruce. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. A motion to Borough Council regards the minutes of November 9th, regular meeting as submitted. I need a motion for that.
So moved.
Bruce and Jason. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. A motion of the Borough Council regards the minutes of November 17th, 2015, budget workshop meeting as submitted. I need a motion.
So moved.
Bruce and Bill. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Any remarks? Anybody opposed? Motion carried. I'll let you take over that, ma'am.
Yes, sir. The first item that we have is current estimate number 2 and final for the 2015 pavement maintenance program. This would be a motion of the Borough Council regarding the remittal of current estimate number 2 and final for the 2015 pavement maintenance program to O'Grandy Industries Incorporated in the amount of $8,703.48 for final work completed. And as a remark, the estimate has been reviewed by Engineer Sykes.
I need a motion.
So moved.
Bruce and Bill. Any remarks? Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Against? Motion carried.
The next item that we have is current estimate number 5 and final, the 2015 point repair contract. I did email this updated one today. If you don't have it, we'll give you the item this today. This would be a motion of the Borough Council regarding the remittal of current estimate number 5 and final for the 2015 point repair contract to Soul Life Construction in the amount of $87,124.59 for final work completed.
Motion.
Mm-hmm.
Bruce and Jason. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Any question? Everybody opposed? Motion carried.
The next item that we have is ordinance number 984 for zoning ordinance update. This will be a motion of the Borough Council regarding the proposed ordinance number 984, an ordinance of the Borough of Bridgeville amending miscellaneous provisions of zoning ordinance as codified in Chapter 27 of the Borough Code of Ordinances. Exhibit A would be the marked copy that was emailed to everyone, and Exhibit B would be the clean copy. So we have a marked copy with the changes so that everyone could see the changes, and then a clean copy with the total document.
I need a motion.
The zoning ordinance update.
Motion, question, right?
Yeah, I make question on the motion.
Good. Yeah, I'm good. I need the motion first, and then we can do the question.
I'll make a motion.
Okay. Bruce with motion second. Question on the motion. It's open.
That's just basically your exhibit A and B, which is your updates.
Right.
Yeah, that's all the updates.
Right, the updates that were incorporated into the ordinance that was already in place.
Just by way of explanation, we tried to make it easier to adopt an ordinance. When you look at legislation and it gets convoluted, amend section B, subsection C, and it becomes a spell. So what we've done is basically simplified the ordinance and said that we're doing this, all these amendments encompassed in the draft in Exhibit A, is the marked document showing all the changes, and Exhibit B is what the ordinance will look like when you hit accept changes on the draft document. So it's basically a way that makes it easier without going through a convoluted process to actually draft the enactment ordinance.
Any more questions? At this time, I ask for a vote. Roll call, please.
Mike Tolmer?
Aye.
Bruce Galducci?
Aye.
Nino Petrocelli?
Aye.
Jason Sarasnik?
Aye.
Bill Cousy?
Aye.
Bill Henderson?
Aye.
Bill Lyons?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Okay, the next item on the agenda is ordinance number 985. This is motion regarding proposed ordinance 985, an ordinance of Borough of Bridgeville relative to the establishment and maintenance of police employees' pension and relief insurance and benefit funder funds, so that certain provisions of pension funder program applicable to the police of said boroughs comply with the Internal Revenue Code of 1986. And as a remark, this ordinance is required condition of fund favorable determination letter issued by the IRS for the police pension plan, and the ordinance has been duly advertised.
I need a motion.
So move.
Bill and Bill. Bill Cousy and Bill Henderson, right?
Right.
Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
The next item is ordinance number 986. This is an ordinance amending ordinance number 981 pertaining to general rates charged for sewage service given to the customers of the Allegheny County Sanitary Authority within the Borough of Bridgeville. The proposed 2016 rates are as follows. The ALCOSAN rate in 2015 was 561. They are raising their rates to 623 per 1,000 gallons. The Borough rate in 2015 was 561, and it will remain the same, 561 per 1,000 gallons. The ALCOSAN service charge was $11.78 in 2015. They are raising the rates to $13.07 per quarter. As a remark, a public hearing was held on today, December 14th at 6:30, to receive citizen comments, and the ordinance and hearing have been duly advertised.
I need a motion.
So move.
Second?
Second.
Question on the motion.
There is nothing magical about $5.61. In fact, there could be some valid argument that says ALCOSAN is going up and we should match that. Many municipalities do that automatically. I point out that our sewage rates continue to go up. Perhaps the boroughs should go up more, perhaps it should go up less. We have a great deal of what they call inflow and infiltration, and we have to correct these issues. But we need to know what more revenue would allow us to buy. And we really don't have a good, I don't have a good handle on it. Now, I truly believe that we need to do a better job. I need to do a better job, and I'm hoping that the rest of you as members of council would see the same. Over the summer, I see people digging up a sewer line. How much inflow and infiltration are we removing? What's our estimates? I know this data exists, I know it's out there. I think we should look at it. At least it's not going up on the borough side this year. So,
that's when you say the borough, you say anybody that's in the borough paying sewage in the borough of Bridgeville?
No. There are two components to your sewage bill. Part of the sewage bill, well, all of it comes to Bridgeville, but ALCOSAN charges us.
ALCOSAN charges us a rate of 561 per 1,000 gallons right now, but we get a bill and we have to pay them quarterly. They also charge us an $11.78 quarterly service charge for the residents. So quarterly we pay, in fact, we're paying it this month, approximately $178,000 to ALCOSAN. That's part of the bill that we charge you. Now the secondary portion of the bill, right now we're at 561 per 1,000 gallons. That's the monies that we use for the projects that we are bonded to under the consent order to, normally our projects run about $350,000 a year. We continue to work on them. The engineers continue to, we continue to videotape and then take the worst of the issues within the borough, and we do a program every year. Our sanitary sewer budget is about $1.2 million. We clean the storm sewers, the sanitary sewers. There's a whole maintenance plan in place. but we're under consent order. So there's a portion of that bill that goes directly to the repairs and maintenance of the sanitary sewers. So there's two components. So ALCOSAN raised their rates, and they'll be raising their rates again next year. It was 17% the first year, and then 11, 11, and 11. We chose this year, feeling that we could do the projects that needed to be done within the parameters of what we were charging and complete those projects. So we chose to hold the line and give the customers a little bit of a break this year. But it will continue to increase because we continue to be under consent order. So
what I'm reading, so I'm understanding, you said basically the borough is picking up, what, 62 cents of the increase on behalf of the community?
We pay the 62 cents of the increase. Yes, right. We have to charge.
They're going to charge you 623, but you're charging me 561.
And we're charging
you 2016.
Right. Okay. The total bill will be $11.84 per 1,000 gallons of water.
Okay.
$6.23 of that $11.84 is charged to us from ALCOSAN. Okay. And that's what I said. We pay about $178,000 a quarter to ALCOSAN that we bring in. And then the other monies are put into a sanitary sewer fund specifically for sanitary sewer repairs and projects. Like TV, aiming, cameraing, and repairs. And we're mandated to do that, so we haven't raised ours this year.
Okay. So they're going up and we're staying, and ALCOSAN, they're going up, you're staying the same, so basically we're still going to see a little bit of
increase. You're going to see an increase because of, right, their service charge is $11.78 per quarter, and it's going up to $13.07. You have monthly bills, so that's broken down into a monthly rate. So it's not 13 or 7 per month. It's for 3 months, so whatever that equals. So.
Very well said. We all know that our sewage bill someday is going to be higher than the utility bill. Guarantee that. You can put all three utilities together. And that's what the sewage bill is going to be someday. Not in the near future, like 5 years, but believe me, it's going up. If I would win the lottery, I would give this borough whatever the $1 million they need. I would line every sewer in Bridgeville. So that's done. Just to answer the mayor, we've been disputing this. Is water. It's impossible with a little bit of money to take care of that. The infiltration, it's big, big, big situation. The engineer, because we want this, we want that. How many times we have to give it to you and the council? We do it, and Lori said it in my full, we do in our meeting and finance that the money we have. Can we line all the sewer in Bridgeville?
I'd love to.
That will fix big percentage. How many million dollars we will need to do that?
Many millions. I think the one thing that has to be done is
That would be, and don't feel bad. All the municipalities in this situation, the whole USA is. We just beg these guys, the legal department, the engineer, to make this longer and longer and longer. And then be postponed. I mean, if these two people in general, well, that municipality, haven't fought for us, the government wants to do this in 10 years. It's impossible.
And the project, one of the things in our projects are driven by different circumstances.
Yeah, the consent order is one thing. We have also the level of defects. We always have to go after the level 5 defects and level 4 defects. We also have some other issues here this year. We've got work that's going to occur on Washington Avenue. You know, with PennDOT, might as well jump on the bandwagon and move that sewer. And there's also work on McLaughlin Run. We're going to do work here. So, you know, we have an operation and maintenance plan in place. It rotates every 5 years. We're supposed to go through and videotape all the sewage. We've been doing that. But then there's these special projects that come up that we have to address. Mm-hmm. And it's best to address them as in conjunction with these other projects. I mean, the Washington Avenue project is, I think, is a real nice opportunity, because originally PennDOT was going to go from Chartier Street to Bower Hill Road here, and water company came along and said they wanted to replace the main from Chartier all the way down to St. Clair Street. So, you know, we was able to look at our information that we had on file and make the determination of what work needs done. We're in the process of putting construction plans together, and we want to be out to bid early part of the year to get that project done. So we don't, I mean, we're saving, we're, by working with PennDOT and the paving and the water company, we're in some respects saving money because there's cost sharing.
Correct, correct. Yes, go ahead, Ben.
There is a very good argument to be made that we should match ALCOSAN's rate increase this year and go to 6.3 ourselves.
Yeah, we raise the last year and you're the one signed
for it.
So we don't know what to do with you.
It's not whether it goes up or down. It's whether we're getting results, okay, and what we're doing. We want the, I'm looking for the right number. Okay?
It is not the right number.
Yes, there is.
It's a huge job. Yes. It isn't the right number. And Mr. Line, Councilman Line, he left me when I said we need $10 million just to do half of them. He said, yeah. Just because Nino said that. And he was right. I would have answered the same thing to myself. You're right. But we do have a big expense.
And we are getting results.
And we're getting results.
We know that. And we're doing work. We're doing
something. Absolutely. Work that right. Is reducing the inflow and infiltration.
Sure.
And it's a continual process.
Let me point out something here. And Joe, I'm taking this off of the winter conditions. Just one sewer line, the one that comes down the water. Okay? Winter conditions, million gallons a day. During dry weather, Bridgeville contributes 2.34 million gallons a day. So when it's dry, 2.34 million gallons a day. When it's wet, 10-year peak flow, right, Joe? 3.54.
Okay.
Almost an extra 1.5 million gallons a day coming from Bridgeville. That's rainwater. That's in our sanitary sewer, not our storm sewer.
And we talked about, you know, the one project here is a demonstration project. Mm-hmm. Of looking at the location of a sanitary sewer that's within a valley that's behind New York Street.
Sure.
And using that as a demonstration project. I think we have the flow data there already, and the possibility of lining that and getting the measurements to see if we can get that reduced past. So, okay, so, you know, that's one of the...
John, let me interrupt you because I'm bringing it up. Just, we know this, but just so that the public understands, when Councilman Petrocelli talks about your sewer bill being the total of your electric, water, and gas bills, it's to try and get rid of this inflow and infiltration.
Right.
That's what we're talking about. And
well,
we need to work
up the level. That way of producing clear bills more and more in the normal day, we're okay. But we got problems.
If we include Upper St. Clair's numbers in that pipe,
because
that pipe starts in Southfield Village. Okay? That pipe starts in Southfield Village. And during dry weather, all of it,
we had someone else agree with that. Okay.
All of it has 4.49 million gallons a day, but the 10-year peak is 18 million gallons a day. That's almost 14 million gallons a day more during a 10-year peak storm event. During a 1-year peak storm event, it's 13.96. That's 10 million gallons a day during a 1-year peak storm of rainwater, who, as Councilman Petrocelli once said to me, you could almost drink it.
That's a lot of information.
Yeah, we're not going to try that, right?
No, we're not. That's so clear.
But so clear, you can drink it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That takes some, I already told you, but it's a big process.
When we went to those meetings with about the vendors, they kept telling us something about a watershed.
What?
Isn't that for stormwater? What is that for?
The watershed is the topography that contributes to the low point of where the water drains. For example, McLaughlin Run is the low point of the watershed. The watershed of McLaughlin Run is very large, extends all the way up into Bethel Park. Everything that flows downhill comes to the McLaughlin Run before it gets to Chartreuse Creek. So there's some watersheds, and then there's regional watersheds.
And just there's storm water, is that?
Well, when you look at it, technically you can look at it, there's a watershed for storm sewers, and there's a watershed for sanitary sewers. And they pretty much are the same, they're parallel, but there's some differences.
Now, are they supposed to have five up in their states? I heard they're having four now.
Five what?
Watershed.
I don't know. I couldn't say it. Not tell you if there's been any change in the watershed.
Every time we brought that up about that water coming down into Bridgeville, down to the Main Street, so they kept telling us, well, we're going to have this many watersheds. Of course, not enough to know what they
are. I think you're talking about retention.
Retention.
Okay, so that's now from five.
The watersheds are the accumulation of the whole area.
We didn't know we were talking.
If you notice our library, perhaps, okay, we have a big retention over there. We could have a more parking lot, but we had to put a big retention. If you ever go there, coming in on your right, you'll see we have a lot of space there. That's retention.
And what we're talking about here really falls a lot into the, an issue that is everywhere. The pipes that were used back in the day were terracotta pipes, they crumble, they break. All that water that's coming in seeps right in, and that's where we're getting this from. That's kind of what the issue is. Like Nino said, there's every sewer around here has some problem of some sort. What do you chisel away at first? But it's on all of us in the end. I mean,
yeah,
as a community, as a whole, everyone.
I just replaced my old house, the old pipe, it all broke. $12,000 just to do the entire cellar. So it's going to happen to the old kid. Now you don't have no water from my house. So far, anyway, that's a good conversation. This is a good argument. It's almost, it's a dream when this is going to be done. I don't know. But anyway, we need. Do we vote on?
Yes.
We have a no. Yeah.
Yes. We're public comment. There is a motion.
Okay. Everybody in favor of with all the figures as it being given to you, and you read it and everything. We need a motion.
Right. So, already.
Oh, okay. Everybody in favor.
Yes.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
Okay, the next item on the agenda is ordinance number 987. This is a motion of the Borough Council regarding proposed ordinance 987, an ordinance fixing the tax rate and levying borough taxes for the fiscal year 2016, and suspending all other revenue acts. And as a reminder, the ordinance has been duly advertised.
Good, can I need a motion?
So moved.
Bruce and Sarasvi. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried.
The next item is ordinance number 988. This is an ordinance amending the Code of Ordinances, Chapter 15, Motor Vehicles and Traffic, Part 4, General Parking Regulations, Section 15-402, parking prohibited at all times in certain locations, specifically to prohibit parking in the following locations on Baldwin Street. On the south end of Baldwin Street, from Baldwin Street to 608 Baldwin Street, and from 668 Baldwin Street to McLaughlin River.
I need
on the north end of Baldwin Street, from Burwood Street to Janeway, and from 607 Baldwin Street to McLaughlin Run Road. And as a remark, the ordinance has been fully advertised.
So moved.
Bill Anderson, and second by Jason. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Motion opposed? Motion carried.
Okay, the next item that we have is resolution number 2015-11. This is a resolution approving the budget for the fiscal year 2016 and adopting the same. The following line items have been adjusted since we had a budget workshop meeting. Line item 310, 210, the EIT current was $493,000 and has been changed to $496,800. Line item 410, 183, the police overtime was $22,000 and has been changed to $25,000. And line item 410, 203, police uniforms was $6,200, has been changed to $7,000. Those two items were changed due to the police contract.
I need a motion.
So moved. I'll second.
Okay, Bruce and Bill. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we tried to compare. Now, I think the chairman tried to confuse me and give me paper they're not equal as the rest of us. I think the folks have done that. So let me find my pages here.
Next to the labor agreement, right?
Right.
Okay. Also, you notice that I have Lori read mine, but the very singing chairman here, he has a beautiful voice, and he read it, that's what should be done. But I choose have Lori do mine. But he read it very well, and I really appreciate how he does it.
That's all right, Trent. So
if I would address Italian people, I would have no problem. Okay, Lori, go ahead.
Yeah, the next is the labor agreement between full-time public works employees in the Borough of Bridgeville. This is a motion regarding this agreement for the calendar years 2016, 17, and 18. And as our marketing agreement includes the following, it's a three-year contract, wage increases 4.5, 4.5, and 4.5, and a deletion of section 2, line 2, which states in part, those hired after the effective date of this agreement, January 1st, 2013, shall be paid at a rate of 70% of wages set out hereto for a period of 6 months, then shall be paid at a rate of 85% for the next 6 months. In a nutshell, it just means when a new employee comes in, they'll be paid at the current rate.
I need a motion.
So moved.
Bruce, and second by Mr. Neal there. And any question about this here? Question? No question? Everybody in favor? Opposed? Motion carried.
The
labor agreement.
The next item that I have is calendar year 2016 meeting advertisement. This will be a motion approving the following meeting dates for the calendar year 2016 and advertising the same. Reorganization meeting will be held the first Monday of January 2016. That will be January 4th. That's 6 p.m. workshop meeting, 6:30 agenda meeting, and 7 p.m. regular meeting. Thereafter, council meetings will be held the second Monday of each month. Workshop meetings at 6, agenda meetings 6:30, regular meetings at 7. Cordial parking recording meetings will be held the third Monday of each month at 7:30. Planning commission meetings are scheduled the last Monday of each month at 7 during the months of January through April and June through October. The main meeting will be held on May 23rd, 2016, and the November and December meetings will be combined and held on December 5th, 2016. The zoning hearings will be scheduled as needed.
I need a motion to accept to those regulations.
I'll make a motion.
Bruce? Can be interested. Everybody in favor?
Well, I have a question. Just bring it up as far as the workshop meetings that we started about 2 years ago. Bring it up for discussion. Is that something that council still wants to advertise and have as a meeting, monthly meeting, or do we can the stuff that we do at the workshop meeting can be brought up as a regular meeting?
The regular agenda meeting.
I mean, yeah, it's a regular agenda meeting.
It just seems like it's a tongue lashing at the workshop meeting.
Yeah. It's turned into
it become unproductive.
Yes.
It's very poorly attended.
We rarely have more than one person or two people here.
The concept was really good. So
yeah.
Didn't pan out.
I'm just wanting to bring it up.
I make a motion to do an amendment.
Shake amendment. Amend the motion.
Yes. Help you out.
Help you out. Thanks.
Any second on that?
Second.
Any question on it?
Let me throw one item on the amendment. Because I concur
having said that, if you'll recall at the last meeting, I suggested that we do something a little differently. Just remember what I said last meeting, and let's think about that as a replacement for these workshop meetings. Okay?
Okay, everybody in favor? Opposed? Motion carried out. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'll do the best I can.
We're not going to tell them.
I should have drank a little more. A motion of the Board of Council approving the December 2015 bill list. Need a motion?
So moved.
Bruce and Bill Lucy. Everybody in favor? Opposed? Motion carried. A motion of the Board of Council approving the payroll December 25th of 2015 to January 1st.
So moved.
January 1st, 2016.
Yeah, the payroll.
Oh yeah, really? I won't be here, so it's okay. Do whatever you want. Who made the motion?
I will.
Okay, everybody in favor?
Opposed?
Motion carried. Monthly report. A motion to accept and pay any commission due the November 2015 real estate tax collector. I need a motion. Are you going to read the rest of it?
Yeah,
you
know.
Are you all right? A motion to accept the October 2015 financial report. Two more. What? I told you you'd give me your own paper.
The police report.
He said all day doing that.
Right here.
Oh. A motion to accept it.
Police report.
Okay. Well, I did the first one. A motion to accept the October.
We're doing it.
Okay. A motion to accept the November 15 police report. A motion to accept the November 2015 zoning report.
So moved.
Okay, good. Second, Bill Pelosi, everybody in favor?
Since you've been going to streamline things.
Honest to God. Well, I drink a little bit before I come in, you see. So I don't try too much. Should I say thank you to the voter, maybe?
More people should do work.
Let's have a fun anyway. Okay, real estate tax refund. A motion to the Board of Council regarding the following real estate tax refund due to the change of the assessment in request by the real estate tax collector. I'm going to give it to all in once, then we'll make one motion, okay? 2015, lot 255G230, $757.35. Patrick and June Dolan. 2014, 255, G230, $757.35 again. That's the same person. 2013, lot to 2055, G230, $757.35. 2015, lot 255 and 128, $539. Current. Berardi Parish of $539. 2015, 255, number 80, $656.50. A grand total, $3,467.55. This is all money that we budget prior to all this return here. So I need a motion to accept all that.
So moved.
And Bill, thank you. Committee reports, administration.
No reports this year.
Wonderful. Finance, oh, that's me.
We have a vote on the real estate.
Oh, yes.
Which
one?
The real estate
tax. Oh, the real estate tax. Yeah.
All in favor?
Only favor. Thank you, Mr. Why did you give me this job? I wasn't prepared. I studied this
sand
first when I was president. I'm sorry. Okay, committee report. You were already obvious. Finance, that's me. We were in a budget. I was too busy to check for if she done all her job right. So, I didn't see no tax collector up there or sheriff department, so we're fine. No report. This is it. Okay, any question for finance? Actually, I want to say one thing. I don't know if everybody knows, at least it's a rumor, that Tevolini is going to go out of business. I don't want to put it on record because it might not be true. But I'm going to come to my, the bottom line. It will be one of the, I don't know, it's chain. They make their own beer, so it's going to attract more young people. I think it's what you guys here should, and the mayor, should study this, see how it goes. You may need more public safety, this military to get a part-time or whatever. It's not my decision. But you know, you bring this younger people, well, you need more watchdog. That's my advice. So, doesn't mean you have to do it. I would be very much in favor. Okay, parks and recreation.
No reports of the park closed.
Okay, that's good. Public Works, Bill.
Well, Public Works, I think we better send out bids for that trash collector to get it done.
Okay.
That's going to be the main issue.
We need a motion.
We want to talk about the track.
We talk about the McCall Arm Park.
We're talking around on the bridge.
Yeah,
well, on the bridge, yeah.
That's, should we put it in formal motion? I don't know. That's a recommendation.
We've already done that.
We've done that in the beginning. Good. Public safety.
The only thing I have, you know, is that we commend the police department and the bargaining unit that we bargained with for a new police contract. They're very professional and work with us. To come up with what we believe is a fair contract. So that'll be addressed a little bit later. Solicitors, copies that. That's it.
Okay. Mr. Mayor.
Light up night was wonderful. The weather cooperated. The singers were fantastic. And a great big thank you to the fire department for the bonfire and for the visit from Mr. and Mrs. Claus and Rudolph. Very nice.
It was a lot of people. It was a beautiful night.
Yes.
Police Chief Chad King.
No report, Councilman Petrocelli. However, I would like to extend a thank you for your many years of service on council.
Thank you. I've
been here since the day I was hired, so thank you once again.
Yeah, my written report, I have nothing to add to that other than on the topic of public safety, Mr. Henderson said your committee concluded, the council concluded negotiations with the bargaining unit. You have previously authorized conclusion of agreement on the terms as briefed by you with the public safety committee. I assisted, actually Lori did most of the heavy lifting on drafting some of the agreement updates, and we concluded that. And it is, the draft is satisfactory and consistent with what you have already authorized. In order to facilitate the execution of the agreement without needing to come back for additional authority, I would recommend, and I've talked to Councilman Henderson about this, and would recommend that. If you wish tonight, you might entertain a motion to authorize the council president to execute the agreement once it has been, once the draft and the contract terms have been reviewed and accepted and executed by the bargaining unit. Since you've already agreed the principle,
to all the terms of it, and you're satisfied that the agreement, as we've written it, meets those terms from our perspective. The only thing left to be done is for the bargaining unit's folks to look over a couple of provisions and language to make sure that the language, the legalese, and the agreement is that they're okay with that. Once they're okay with it, we're already okay with it, then you don't need to come back to council. If you merely entertain a motion to authorize the council president to execute the proposed 2016 to 2018 police collective bargaining agreement upon those same terms and conditions as previously authorized by council, once that final contract document language reflecting those terms has been accepted by the bargaining unit, and once the executed agreement has been returned to you by the bargaining unit.
Do you want a contingency on that, or just?
That is actually a built-in.
It is, it's a built-in.
Okay.
So, well, I'd like to make that motion.
Bill, and second, Gardici. Any question on the motion? Everybody in favor? Opposed? It went through. Everything's fine. Question? Okay, engineer.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Glad to hear quite a few items. We covered the pavement maintenance program with your payment to El Grande. The contract B, Borough Road, repairs have been delayed until spring since we've got the wall work done. Jet Jack's almost done with the 2014 CCTV clean inspection. Solite finished the 2015 plug repairs, and Jet Jack's working on the liners. The Washington Avenue water main replacement, briefly touched on that before. We met with people from PennDOT and Pennsylvania American Water. Lane's going to delay the paving from Chartiers to St. Clair Street until we get the water, until the water company gets done with their work, and we'll be doing our sanitary sewer repairs in that same period. Received word from PennDOT that McLaughlin Run Road will be resurfaced during 2016. We reviewed our CCTV information of the sanitary sewers and determined there's portions that can be repaired with liners. So we're working on preparing documents to bid that out. The 2015 sanitary CCTV clean inspection with Insight. We've been working on a punch list item list with them in the last 2 weeks, and they should be done here before the end of the month. Mr. Fultz mentioned about the Washington James development. And the I-79 corridor study, the manager and I attended a meeting here week before last. I guess PennDOT is doing their own study to possibly widen 79 to 3 lanes in each direction, where it isn't already done between the rest areas and Kerwin Heights. And we had informed this group of individuals at South Point, and we informed them of the Route 50 task force and provided them copies of all the information that we've been developing over the last 2 years. There was no internal communication at PennDOT to share this information, so maybe this meeting was a good thing. So we brought them up to speed. So that's all I have, unless you have any questions, and I'd like to wish everybody Merry Christmas.
Any question for the engineer?
Just one reminder, I know you talked about McLaughlin and resurface, that striping has been an issue for us down there, so when that comes up,
let's talk.
Yeah, let's talk about it. I'm going to be sure that we're going to be curbing down there too, because there's a lot
of curbing, yes,
yeah, the curbs. And the sidewalks,
yeah,
go with it. We can speed that up.
I did talk about it, so the phone had not a lot of striping down there. They say they look at it,
we got a bill and maybe get some diagrams like we did for down here in front of the post office so that they change the line pressure between Chartiers and Hickman at no cost to us.
Yeah, and you know, take pictures where the old stripes were.
Yeah,
where they grind them off.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Fire Chief.
Thanks, Mr. President. I kind of got my report. As you can see on it, last month we were a little busy, not real bad, a couple fires. Just a note on her, a couple of them were we assisted in Crafton and up in Pensbury. Thanksgiving night we were in Pensbury, where everybody missed dinner. So, you know, like I say, that's what we do. That's what we're here for. So, but the other thing is, luminaries are
pretty much in and ready to go. And last thing I got is Santa and Mrs. Claus coming around town on Saturday, starting at 1 o'clock. So look for them. And from the fire department, wish everybody happy holidays and a safe one. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you. Sandridge is not here. A library. Becky.
Oh, good. Finally got a chance. Listen, I want to just thank everybody for 2015, your attention and support of the Bridgeville Public Library, and I look forward to a positive relationship continuing in 2016. And Mr. Petrocelli, I would like to thank you for everything that you have done and do, and your patriotism as evidenced by your little presence of the red, white, and blue flags that you provide to the library. And thank each and every one of you.
Thank you.
And have a happy new year.
Thank you. Borough manager.
I didn't provide a report today. There are just a couple things as an update. There will be some positions open on some boards and commissions beginning with us Monday in January. We have had some individuals that are serving in those positions give me letters of interest that they would like to continue to serve. I have also advertised openings in December 10th and 17th. Trip, which will be in Bridgeville Business, if anybody else wants to see the letters of interest. And they're due December 31st. So I just wanted to let you know about that. Also, the Southwest Corridor study that we and I attended the first meeting in January of last year.
Yes.
And PennDOT is, what is the firm? URG?
It's URS.
URS. They commissioned them to do a study of the whole Southwest Corridor and all of the main streets.
Streets and critical points, and looked at you know, where there's bottlenecks, and I think what the results is going to be like the low-cost solutions to what can be done to improve traffic flow, mainly probably line striping, but that's
smaller
projects.
And so Joe and I got an email that they wanted the two of us back to go over that,
the results.
To go over the results. That'll be sometime in January. Also, environmental planning and design to do the neighborhood planning studies. There are drafts that are complete. Carolyn would like to meet with council and maybe the planning commission at an informational meeting to review the drafts. She actually, especially the second draft that she did for the Ridge Road area, she would like for me to present that to you at the meeting so that she can go over it and specifically explain the how and wherefores of of the plans. So it should be at the beginning of January. I'm waiting for her to give me a few dates, and then I'll try to coordinate with everyone. And lastly, we are applying for a multimodal transportation fund grant for Charter Street. It's due December 18th. My cabinet is working on that at Gateway, and that's another shot at trying to get Charter Street widened. I just want to say that it's been a privilege.
Well, it's my privilege, as
my
you know.
I've been here for 24 years, and
Joe has
been here the entire time, and he's been helping me and teaching me along the way, and it's been a privilege. And we love you.
Thank you.
So, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Just to replica one of the words she say on the advertising, if it is any opening, you can consider it. Don't fire anybody in some because they're doing a good job. So, I'm not going to send you any letter. If it is any opening, consider it. Go business. New business.
All right, Tom. Nino, we'd like to present this to you. Everybody's been thanking you all night, and it is true. And you I want to personally thank you. It's been a great help to me. The little description says, the Borough of Bridgeville, I'd like to thank Nino Petrocelli Sr. and grateful appreciation for your many years of service to our borough and citizens.
Thank you. This is not a social club. You get what you give in. And thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you to everybody. Thank you. Journey, I need a motion.
I have one more thing. On the ordinance we passed tonight, I have something to consider. On chapter 27, section 1 through 5, maybe we can have Planning Commission take a look at that and see if our friends and zoning ordinance, they can take a look and get back to us by the March meeting. Some issues that, you know, that are pending that maybe we should take a little closer look. Look, there's a lot of information, a lot of documents that really review and digest, and, you know, in the process, not saying we missed anything, but it's always good to have a second set of eyes with some issues that we have out there that we can maybe improve and make it better and stronger.
Are you put this in form of motion or just a recommendation? Bill, you want to say something?
Yeah, same thing.
Okay, you made a motion. Bill accepted. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Any remarks? Everybody opposed? Motion carried. Journey?
I'd like to ask for an executive session. I don't want to put it down on with Upper St. Clair as far as what they got going on. I think it'd be appropriate if we discuss what they're proposing so that we're not getting naively throughout everything that's going on. So,
is there something you want to say before?
Was the nature of the motion you were making with regard to sending stuff back to the Planning Commission with regard to the specific items?
We had section chapter 27, 1 through 5, and we're here.
Okay, and if you're referencing the motion document you're looking at, I'm sorry, okay. Those are not sections of the ordinance, just to be clear. The things that you want the Planning Commission to study, and everybody has this document, obviously, you know, the audience doesn't know you were remarking on it. They were talking about having the Planning Commission look at a number of the uses in the mixed business district that are designated as conditional uses and considering whether some of those should maybe be permitted uses as opposed to conditional uses. The second item regarding whether there should be an amendment to clarify a definition for parking space. Thirdly, whether they should study whether the overlay district that we talked about that's on Baldwin and Block and whether that should extend to all parts of the business district except for the downtown, except for the Washington Avenue Main Street. And then, as has been prior discussion, we talked about looking at our design standards. As the folks at Intent know that that didn't become part of the update this time, but that's just some discussion about the study. So that would be the other item for the Planning Commission to look at. And then the looking at off-street parking and building requirements, I guess, making recommendations regarding those. Is that fairly covered, Scotty? If you would like to have this written motion that you made make part of the minutes, then that would get more clear marching orders.
Okay. So you want to put that motion on whenever you each one of you has it?
Do you want this document part of that motion?
The secretary, the manager has it. A motion. Just for public consumption, you knew what you were, the motion was, you just made, just wanted to make sure.
Okay.
The audience.
Yeah, this document.
So that's including on record.
And you would ask about the executive session of our potential legal issues around this, around the meeting.
Yes.
I would like to request the executive session with the attorney to update you regarding the ideas. Yes, you can adjourn.
If you're not investing information,
you're not anticipating taking any further consequential action.
Okay. The motion for adjourning is in place. I need a second. Everybody in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.